Hi everyone. In this part, I will mention about indeterminate forms, that is, I will use L'Hopital's rule to find some limits. Let me first give the first type, and I want to start with the theorem. Suppose that we have one of the following cases. The first case, limit of f of x over g of x is equal to 0 over 0 when x tends to a number a or infinity, or if this expression is equal to infinity over infinity, here a is any number or plus minus infinity. A number or plus minus infinity. If we have this case, then this expression is equal to limit of f prime over g prime, again when x tends to the same number. So we have this equality when limit of f over g is equal to 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity. It is called L'Hopital's rule, French mathematician. So let's solve some problems. Example 1. Limit when x tends to 1. 1 minus x divided by ln x. As you see, when x tends to 1, numerator becomes 0, denominator becomes 0, since ln x tends to 0 when x tends to 1. So this is equal to 0 over 0. So we have 0 over 0 case. This is why we can use L'Hopital's rule. So let's use L'Hopital's rule. So this equality becomes is equal to, let's say, x tends to 1, derivative of numerator, which is minus 1, divided by derivative of denominator. Derivative of ln x is 1 over x. So if you substitute this expression, you will have limit when x tends to 1 minus x. When x tends to 1, you have minus 1. You do not have an indeterminate form anymore. So it is solved. Another example, example 2. Limit when x tends to 0, 1 minus cosine 3x divided by 2x squared. Let's first look at the expression. What do we have for this limit? When x tends to 0, this expression goes to 1, cosine 0 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0, so you have 0 in numerator, divided by 0 in denominator. Since we have 0 over 0 case, of course we can use L'Hopital's rule. So let's use L'Hopital's rule. Let's apply L'Hopital's rule. X tends to 0. Derivative of numerator. Derivative of 1 is 0. Derivative of minus cosine 3x. Derivative of inside. Derivative of cosine is minus sine. So you have minus minus, which is plus plus. Derivative of inside is 3. And derivative of cosine is sine. You do not change the inside of the parentheses. Divided by derivative of denominator, which is 4x. Let's check when x tends to 0. When x tends to 0, numerator tends to 0. Sine 0 tends to 0. And denominator also tends to 0. You have again 0 over 0 case. So it means we have to apply L'Hopital's rule again. let's apply again. Derivative of numerator 9, derivative of inside times 3, 9. Let me first write the limit expression, of course. Limit when x tends to 0. Derivative of numerator is 9. Derivative of sine is cosine, not minus cosine. You do not change the inside of the parentheses. And final derivative of denominator is 4. When x tends to 0, as you see, cosine, this expression tends to 1. And you have 9 over 4 as a result. The next example, let's solve some more problems to understand the concept. So what do you think about this question? When x tends to 0, x squared plus x divided by exponential x minus 1. So what do you think about this question? When x tends to 0, numerator tends to 0, denominator also tends to 0, since e to the power 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So you have 0 over 0 case. So it means we can apply L'Hopital's rule. Let's apply limit when x tends to 0, derivative of numerator is 2x plus 1. Derivative of denominator is exponential function itself. When x tends to 0, denominator tends to 1, numerator tends to 1, you have 1 over 1, which is 1. Numerator tends to 2, you have 2 over 1, which is 2. Okay? So let's solve some more problems. Example. Limit x tends to 0, a to the power x minus b to the power x divided by x here. A and b are positive numbers. When x tends to 0, a to the power x tends to 1, b to the power x tends to 1, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, as you see, and denominator also tends to 0. So it means we can apply L'Hopital's rule. Let's apply. This limit expression becomes derivative of denominator is 1, as you see, and derivative of a to the power x. Do not forget that a to the power x is an exponential function, since a is here a number, okay? And the power is a function. Base is a number. The power is a function. This is why it's called exponential function. So derivative of a to the power x is, when you remember the formula, a to the power x times the ln of base, ln a. And the same thing is happening for the second function, b to the power x, ln b. Okay? So we have this expression. As you see, you can take ln a and ln b to the outside or to the in front of the limit expression, right? So you have ln a times, and since denominator is 1, limit of a to the power x when x tends to 0 minus ln b limit b to the power x, x again tends to 0. So let's continue. When x tends to 0, and do not forget that a and b are positive numbers, okay? When x tends to 0, a to the power x tends to 1, b to the power x tends to 1. So we have ln a minus ln b. Using the properties of ln function, you have ln a over b. Okay? It's all. So let's solve some more problems. Example, another example. example. Limit, in this case x tends to infinity, 5x minus 2 over 7x plus 3. Okay. When x tends to infinity, as you see, denominator and numerator tend to infinity. It's possible to use L'Hopital's rule here. But you may remember the formula: when you have polynomials in both numerator and denominator, and when x tends to infinity, the answer is the coefficient of the polynomials, which have the highest degree. So in this case, the answer is 5 over 7. It's very clear. But let's use L'Hopital's rule. When x tends to infinity, numerator and denominator tends to infinity. You have infinity over infinity case, right? So it's possible to use L'Hopital's rule. Here, let's apply L'Hopital's rule. Derivative of numerator is 5. Derivative of denominator is 7. So limit of a number when x tends to something is a number. The answer is 5 over 7. So, another example here. Limit of 3 to the power x divided by x squared plus x minus 1. When x tends to infinity. When x tends to infinity, numerator and denominator tend to infinity, go to infinity. So we have to apply L'Hopital's rule here. So I leave the rest to you as a homework, and the answer is infinity here. Another homework is this: limit when x tends to infinity, ln x divided by x to the alpha. Here alpha is a positive number. And the final homework, and the answer of the second one is 0, the answer of first one is infinity, and the final homework, limit x tends to pi from left, sine x divided by 1 minus cosine x. And the answer of the final homework is 0. And my question is that, is it possible to apply L'Hopital's rule to the final question? I will continue to teach type 2 for indeterminate case in the next video.